sometimes it's a little bit of a delay, let him get his feet, and then we move on and we have to discuss sort of hyperfusion calculations, you see. So, I don't know what it's on here, we try to imagine it, but this is just on here.
And people from many processes are considered priority for the species. And not just the basis, but the CP2, the vector models, and the genetic system.
advanced, you plug in your camera rules to manipulate your objects. Typically, you have a loop in the glass, you have loops, so you have to simplify it. So you get tensor in the glass, which then you have to reduce the scalar in the glass. But then, I mean, there are things in the time of passing the day, there are systematic procedures. So how you go from a sensor into a set of scalar in the glass that you want to do. So in principle, this was a problem that was solved really many years ago. But practically, things don't really work when you go to high multiplicity. Essentially, what works is the number of fiber diagrams that you have to do stands to a factorial. In terms that you obtain, once you start doing the sensor reduction, also goes factorial. And practically, what happens is that you get many large expressions, and then you have to make them stability. So even if you try to program this growth force, what happens is that you already have large accelerations, gigantic accelerations, and your final result is completely in this precision. So in the years between 2004 and 2014, I think that's the last 10 years, there were a lot of great ideas on how to do and loop calculations without really computing loop diagrams. Essentially, mainly using generalized unitaries. So mainly the idea is that instead of computing loop diagrams, you cut these diagrams, and then you produce one loop, which is essentially a product of optional trailer diagrams. So you move the product of being one loop to one trailer, products of trailer optional diagrams. And there are many techniques and many improvements and many things. So here, this is a view of now 2 years, which really sort of works out some examples on this unitary method. And just to show some of the breakthrough in technology, if you use fiber diagrams, so what people often look at are purely one amplitude. It's not only because it's particularly interesting. If you have a few of the amplitudes, you only have jets in the final state. And this is not a clean process, as you can see. Multi-jet production is the most complicated one, because you don't have electric to take you to the system, it's not very important. But it's a sort of a playground for fields. So what is shown here is, in terms of the number of fields, this is a 4 one amplitude, 5 one amplitude, 6 one amplitude, computed sort of using more standard techniques. And this is what one could then do using this unitary based techniques. You can really compute all of them, because you can program something that is efficient and stable, even at high intensity. And of course, okay, this is a playground, but this has been really applied to processes of interest, as you can see. And so this type of fix is something that is now really close. So now there's still work, there's still done. So mainly on two directions. One is to sort of have something that is really completely automated. Not only GCD corrections, also electron corrections, and in principle something like Markov Fly, also for new physics models. Really like Markov Fly, for example, in terms of the smart loop. And then the other group is sort of focused on really pushing even more multiplicity. Doing phase space integration is difficult, so still sort of still sort of using analytical techniques to sort of improve the curiosity results. And just to show now that things are effectively automated, this is a list of processes. So this is where the vector model plus chase, this is how it goes on safe. Vector boson pairs such as we see a huge list of things. And one can also, this is something from one paper now. 3 vector bosons and jets, 4 vector bosons, heavy quarks and jets, heavy quarks and vector bosons, single top plus other things, single Higgs pair production, heavy quarks and jets. So the reason I show this list is to show you that in fact the things are really automated. A few years ago, each of these lines would have been a separate paper. People published papers on that for the introduction and also. And now things in fact are really automated. Still, you see that the multiplicity can't be too high. And if you go to high multiplicity, still you need a lot of computer power. But things are really automated. So this is the last top words and bosons. And you see after the edge of work. So what the issue here? So take one of these boxes, it's something that's suggested. What is shown here is the energy of the second jet, so we can between 0 and 500. What is shown here is the linear correction, blue, and this is the energy correction. This is the logarithmic scale. So here you see that the high energy has gigantic growing corrections. And what you see here is the same plot, but with a different scale choice. Here the scale choice is one way to solve it. Here the scale choice is related to the mass of the W boson, and what you see here is the scale growth, which is the sum of the largest energy in the vector. So you see that if you look at this, you will say, well, my perturbative function is not converging well, too, but I have really gigantic negative corrections. If you look at this here, here you see the ratio plot, this is essentially, you see, the perturbative function you can have large energy corrections that have nothing to do with having chosen a large scale choice. and a lot of them have physical training. Oh, for instance, an example that is a fear effect that you can have in tendons, or that you have some enhanced and common tendons, and so on. The thing is that whenever you change scale, whenever you volume affects from one scale to another, you're generating what is called a single log. So alpha times the log of the ratio of the scales. In a cross-section, you have a double log, so this way. So alpha log of the ratio of scale squared. So whenever you try to observe the double log into a single log of scale, so you're doing a mistake. And the thing is that if you tend to dig into the scale in a physical way, and then vary, you can use it as a little bit of scale squared. If you choose a scale and consider your solid field square, then it becomes analytical to sort of field scale variation, not your scale adjustment. Because you choose a scale, so it doesn't have a possibility here. You choose a scale when you are fitting in the plateau. But then if you write a scale, nothing happens, so you feel that the field is very small, but it doesn't have to be right. So you lose this handle on the field. The other issue with analytical calculation is nearly partial shower. So if you want analytical calculation, I should, even it's more advanced, you have maybe 4 or 5 particles in the final state. At your HC, you have maybe 30 or something like this. So you want to sort of still allow these particles to have a final state addition and final addition. And this is something that, in fact, was now about 2 years, 10 years ago. There are 2 main methods of doing it. One is in a series, and one is in power. And now these tools and low end partial shower are really used by all advanced HC analysis. And I mean, what was difficult is to understand whenever you have partial shower, essentially, what you're doing is you take your hard event and you allow it to do a very soft addition. But you don't want to double count, this is a very good thing in analytical calculation. This was really difficult. But that was something that is really well under control. The last issue is what is called the support energy zone, that I will assist us later. So, in there are 2 strategies, I think there are 2 methods. In this method here, you compute with a double count, and you just select it. And in the other approach, you sort of generate things in such a way that the hardest emission, so this is the hardest emission is from the NLO. And then you don't have issues of double counting. No, but it's not simple. No, it's not simple. No, they are not. In particular, so in this approach, what you do is depends a lot on bimodal approaches. It depends on the partial shower. So this approach really works in PTO with showers, and here what is expected depends on which one you're using. So it's that. PTO has various versions, has also PTO. No, of course, they are not simple, but once then. No, this is the problem. So what is this problem? So suppose you have different next leading order calculations. So I compute heat plus jet, some of you have computed heat plus digest, and this was yesterday all the time. So you have 3 different calculations that now are all in power back, so they are actually in a loop plus button shower. But these 3 calculations have different accuracies in different ranges of fixed things. So the pure heat calculation describes the first jet only leading order because it comes from the real addition. And all of our jets come from the button shower. If you take heat plus 1 jet, the spectrum of the leading jet is really discarded in the accuracy. The second jet is leading order accuracy, and the other jet comes from the button shower. But you can't use this calculation to compute an inclusive fixed cross section if you don't put a cut on the video of the jet. In fact, this cut is the jet. So if you take an analog calculation, what is this mean? What is that? So in fact, I don't know what you're seeing. So the dependence is next to the in the soda offering your time, the things become a soft of a leader, you have this sort of feeling about the accuracy, because you have very simple to implement, once you know how to do it, it's just straightforward. But the inclusion of soda post factors is very important, because what this tells you is that your jet cross section, for instance, the Higgs plus one jet cross section, may become finite, even without the cut of the jet. So, it then allows you to merge, if this equation is finite, what we showed with the indicator here is that, in fact, not only you can make it finite, but you can make it finite in such a way that it can be NLO accurate even for positive production. So, when you apply this mean procedure, for instance, the Higgs plus one jet, your NLO accurate also for its production. So essentially, the Nilo theorem of Faubeck deals with these three issues of an equation. Gives you a procedure to choose the scale, allows you to merge these relations, and somehow bring it back to the solution. So, now there's nothing new here. First of all, those scales are shown in the number, in the sense that this is the hardest of those, but they can be prepared to see after the number effect of two. So, this is the form check. So, on the other hand, much like the form for the student. So, the form of the Suda Coffer factor is arbitrary at higher orders, but the lowest of the coefficients are the same. So, then this process is different alpha. So, what we would do is we would do the one. One can be by hard, one can be by soft. And then the fact that this range is soft and this is a...
I understand.
And then it doesn't matter how
it's
done, I get
this equation. But when I think that if I have two different scales, I have a factor of freedom that would start very well. I'm probably going to have a reason like that. I'm only one scale.
Okay, so here you can write them all together one.
Okay,
but not too much at the end. You can leave it to the but at the end, sort of, usually, the range comes from where both scales are up and both scales are carried down. So this is usually what you should have just
done. I see. But it's not even that you are physically negotiating alpha.
So here you are using the Fender scale, then you vary the material called 2 using one and the other two. Here you have your scale that comes with this procedure, and each one you can vary either independently or practically, it doesn't make a big difference, because the band usually comes with both scales up or both scales down. It's like a simple complete convention.
Complete convention, like a
phase, like a process. So then you keep
it.
So if you take this on one of the calculations W Z subjects, this is our complete data. So this is W with the subject Z subjects. So this is the two jet calculation, which is in the procedure. Then we can look at the cross section for two jets. This is now half a band that they vary these scales. And here this point is under sixes. What you see is it grows also for higher specificities, but also grows for lower specificities, in point nothing. When you normal calculation, you essentially can't you don't have a number here, it's only just a reference. So here you see in this case, I have to say this is the only point that we have any work. But what you see and what we want to understand is that you're making a lot of the higher order directions also the system. Now, what I should say is that all this, and you know, looking at the highly specific balance, it was not needed by looking for the fixed salary. Now, if you look at SUSY, or SUSY searches, this is the SUSY searches, you see that you have already developed an exclusion of one TV energy scale. And for topics, I would say about the few TV. So, somehow, all this looking for TV style, it was not very successful after now. The other thing that one has to keep in mind from you know that there is the Higgs was discovered in this region here. This is a region which is very, primarily very nice because it's very rich. So, you have the Higgs and the Higgs in Vada, and then you can see a lot of the TV most of it. And so people that started looking at this virus came and said, as I told you, once you know the mass of the Higgs, everything is correct. So you can look for variations from the standard model pattern. And what is happening now, or what happened, is that essentially there is no difference. No matter what the difference, you can see an absolute variation. Here, up to 2 years ago, all we had exchange data. So many things are now being computed in the next video, and those will be important for this type of researches. And hello, also that hello, right hand in hand with the developer, hello, and Fatoucha. So now, what about the next video, and Fatoucha? Of course, this is essentially a must. You have your highest category procedure, and you have the benefits of having your organization model, exclusive suspension, and so on. So let me give you an example. So, in the case of fixed production, these are essentially the elements that enter a next video organization. So you have this one that I have already here, a 0-1 loop, this is 0-1 loop, and fixed plus two parts at 3. Now, if you take a 6+1 calculation in power, like schematically drawn here, you see that you have already this 0-1 loop, and you have this 3. And I told you that if you upgrade this into video, and this is the proper factors, what you tell you is you can essentially get also those, like 0 and 1. So you're almost done, but you still have what you're missing, is still the sound of the correction. So this is also sort of summarized again in this table here. So Milo gives you this sort of merged generator. So you have fixed and then fixed and then fixed and then fixed. And if you want something next to you, the only thing is you get a small difference here, because you don't have the double here, so this is simply not there. But you're almost there. So how can you now upgrade this? The observation is that for a simple process like fixed, the one kinematics is determined by the rapidity distribution. So if you compute your fixed rapidity distribution next to the solid water, and you compute it with this merged generator, and you take the ratio of those two, this will get the fact that it is 1+r² What it means is that if you take this predictions of this generator, it will wait for this factor, because it's alpha squared, it will not change your annual accuracy, but it will give the correct fixed rapidity at next to the solid water. So it essentially allows you to upgrade this to next to the solid water. So now I'm running out of time, so you can see that this was done, so this was the first time I first started showing you fixed production, and one can see how well it actually compared to the analytical summation that exists. This is for the fixed spectrum, for the jet spectrum, and there's lots of room for these comparisons. The same that we learned recently also for the YAN, to do it from a complicated process is extremely quite difficult. Now, I think I'm running out of time, so let me skip this last and just give you the conclusions. And let's see now. I think the rapid classic data from my one, and much more we can now next year, from in the next 3 years, from what we see, and then later. The field will advance faster by sort of trying to extend the range of this experiment. This you can do by having larger predictions. You will have more precise and faster searches, and you get it by doing precision predictions. At the end, I think the aim is to give the best picture at the end of the run of what has been discovered, what has been re-excluded in the best possible way. And this is, of course, important now also in terms of planning future projects. Now, the point is, we see the last 10 years of the last more now we're thinking, about 10 years ago, for instance, from the one that's been known, and also going to do two changes, and also merging a matching the NRO buffer shower. Now, most of these thoughts didn't come just to force calculation, because really many things were a lot about developing ideas and techniques. So I think it's a very exciting plan to generate some of those calculations.